Hi, Genevieve Jacobs from Region Media. And this week's news update comes, I wish we had smell-o-vision because this is sumptuous. I'm at the truffle farm at Majura. It's a cracking season for the truffles with a tray of freshly harvested beauties, many of which will be on their way to the export markets in France or in Japan. With me, Nathan McDowell from Van Duvin, Damien Brabender from Otis Dining Hall, and Jason Messman, who owns the truffle farm. Jason, cracking season for the truffles. They need a lot of frost and boy, we've had it.
Yeah, it's been an amazing growing season. So now we've got these for Canberrans to enjoy.
And I know that the Canberrans absolutely love their truffles, that they've flocked to it. And this has been a bit of a difficult season though, hasn't it?
Yeah, off the back end of last year, which was difficult with the fires. Now we've got COVID hitting us in the peak of the season. So this is an opportunity for Canberra locals to get out and see the farm, purchase tickets that haven't been available for almost 5 years.
Yeah, well, and that's absolutely a tribute to how the truffle industry has grown and flourished in this region, and the climate is absolutely right. We've got the food lovers to burn. Nathan, you would have noticed from Van Duvin that there's been this really tricky situation with the passing traffic from Sydney. The people going down to the snow have not been here, but there are still opportunities, aren't there?
Yeah, absolutely. So I guess we focus mostly on wineries, and then each season we kind of look at something where we can bring in what's happening in Canberra. So Canberra, winter, truffles. So we've tried to team that up with our wine tours. And as you know, the wineries, they've had a tough, you know, 2 years. They lost their 2020 vintage from the smoke taint and the hail, and they're just releasing their white wines for 2021. So it's a great time to get out. It's beautiful out there.
Yeah. And Damien, to you, you've been involved with bringing truffles to the table and the truffle experience during this part of the season. Tell me what you're pairing truffles with, what we should be eating these gorgeous fruits of the earth with at this stage.
I think one thing we're very lucky to do, as funny as it sounds, we get to pair good food with good company, unlike a majority of the rest of the country at the moment. So we can make sure that we are getting together with friends, with family, and experiencing and sharing these fantastic local and new experiences as well. Whether it's on the plate, whether it's at the end of a truffle shaver, or in the glass next to the plate, I think it's something that we can really be proud of. I think we all agree we produce amazing wine, we produce amazing food, and for so long we have queues out the door where maybe the 15th or the 20th person is Canberra, and this time, you know, jump straight to the front of the queue, be the queue, and holiday here and experience this stuff.
Be a Canberran and be the queue. I've been to a fair few truffle feasts in my time. Sometimes they can be very elaborate. We know that fat carries the flavour with the truffles. I have to say one of my preferences would probably be for a truffled egg over pasta, something very simple. How do you like to do your truffles?
I'm much the same as yourself. I mean, taking truffles, putting them into butter, I'm not going to give away too many recipes, but if you want to pop out to the farm on the weekends, obviously we can share all the details and show you how to do it. But yeah, you're exactly right. Using things that are heavy in fat, and eggs as well. Eggs are fantastic. Pasta, keeping simple dishes, but also using truffles in everyday dishes that people wouldn't normally use them in.
Well, the truffle toasty, for example.
I see you saw what I had for lunch this morning. So it's, yeah, truffle toasted sandwiches, truffled hamburgers, everything like that as well. It doesn't have to be decadent and had a chef table, restaurants and things. You can use your truffles at home. And that's the message we try and really get out to Canberrans here. When you come and visit us and you come and join us on the weekend, get to go out, meet the puppies, find a truffle, and then I'll tell you how to cook it and how to use it in your everyday and share it with your friends and family.
I reckon that's actually the height of luxury, things that are simple but superb quality. Nathan, what's your bet for what you should drink with a truffly dish? What do you like?
I mean, I'm very partial to any cool climate Canberra red, so we make some beautiful Shiraz Viogniers, as you would know, the McKellar Ridge, the guys from Clonakilla. That would be my go-to, but maybe a nice crisp Riesling to cut through some of the fattier dishes. That would go quite nice.
I like the sound of all of that. That Shiraz Viognier from Clonakilla with some Canberra truffles and maybe, as I said, the pasta, the shavings, superb. Jason, what's on offer out here at the Truffle Farm? And we've heard all the encouragement to come out and actually get the chance to participate. What can people do?
Well, obviously we've spoken about good food, good wines that Canberra is known for. Probably the star of the show as well, other than the truffles, is the dogs. So let's not forget them, the reason they're the logo, because people have a little bit of everything. You've got your green thumbs that can come out, learn how to start their own truffle farm if they really want to. Then we've got the dogs. We've got 8 of those, 6 of which are rescues. And unlike the dogs at the airport where they say don't touch them, we're all about giving them a cuddle. So something to look forward to on a weekend.
Yeah, and look, that is actually a lovely experience. I've actually got a truffle oak in my own garden at home at the farm. Haven't actually got around to digging anything up yet. I might need to borrow one of the dogs and make it all work. But look, come and support one of Canberra's really flourishing homegrown industries. We've got the perfect climate for truffles. We've got the wine to match. The tourist experience is here. And maybe it is just an advantage that all the blow-ins from Sydney can't come along. We can enjoy ourselves. So everyone here is encouraging you to get amongst it with the truffles. Also making news this week on the site, we're talking about the 24th anniversary of the Canberra Hospital implosion and the tragedy of Katie Bender's death. Gavin Dennett, who's one of our sub-editors at the Riot Act, has written about being there on the day and his own personal experience of that. Ian Bushnell's talking about the perilously tight rental market in the ACT and just how high those rents are, where to look if you're looking for a house. Amelia Bidgegood has written about where you can get a $10 meal that doesn't involve anything to do with fast food. So no crowns, no kernels, no clowns, but how to get the lowdown on really delicious, terrific food feasts. And also a lovely article from John Thistleton about Matt Casey. Now, a lot of you will know Matt perhaps from Goulburn. He's a lovely, gentle, very community-minded bloke. Back in the 80s, he was a hard-boiled detective, and we've got a great yarn that opens with John pointing a 38 at the head of one of the worst drug dealers in New South Wales. It's a rip-snorting yarn. All that and more on the Riot Act, where we are all about the deep local stories. We've got a weekly newsletter and a daily digest. Sign up for those. They'll drop into your email inbox. Come and join the great big local Canberra conversation. And come and enjoy the truffle feast. I'm Genevieve Jacobs. This is Region Media.